As we explore the vast depths of the ocean, we discover more and more mysteries that lie hidden in plain sight. And yet, perhaps none are as intriguing as those that remain buried in the icy depths of Antarctica. From subglacial lakes to enigmatic ice tunnels, this frozen continent holds countless secrets waiting to be unearthed. In fact, it's not just the coldest, but the most mysterious continent on Earth, and 2023 may just be the year we finally unlock its greatest enigmas. It's time to explore them all. Hidden World. Underneath a massive Antarctic ice shelf, in a cathedral-like cavern hundreds of meters high, are swarms of little creatures that are similar to shrimp. These creatures are part of a recently discovered underwater ecosystem that, until recently, had remained an ice-locked secret. A group of New Zealand researchers made the discovery of the ecosystem 500 meters below the ice, in what is thought to be an estuary. This location is located hundreds of kilometers from the margin of the Ross Ice Shelf. Antarctica, New Zealand provided financial assistance to scientists from the universities of Wellington, Auckland, and Otago, as well as the National Institute of Water and Atmospherics and the Geological and Nuclear Sciences, so that they may explore the potential role that the estuary could play in the climate-induced melting of ice shelves. Amphipods are small animals that come from the same ancestry as lobsters, crabs, and mites. When they dug down through the ice and into the river, their camera was invaded by amphipods. For a while, we thought something was wrong with the camera, but when the focus improved, we noticed a swarm of arthropods around 5 millimeters in size, said Craig Stevens of NIWA. When the focus improved, we noticed a swarm of arthropods. We've done experiments in other parts of the ice shelf and thought we had a handle on things, but this time there were a lot of big surprises thrown up. According to Stevens, the effort was motivated in part by concerns regarding climate change. Nevertheless, there was also an element of discovery involved in the mission. We were giddy with excitement since the presence of all those species swimming around our gear indicates that the area contains an important ecosystem. After noticing a groove in the ice while analyzing satellite imagery of the Ross Ice Shelf, the person in charge of the research, Hugh Horgan from Te Haerenga Waka, Victoria University of Wellington, was the first to discover the estuary. He made the discovery after noticing the groove. According to Horgan, although researchers have known for some time that there is a network of hidden freshwater lakes and rivers beneath the Antarctic ice sheets, these bodies of water have not been directly studied at this time. Being the first person to witness and sample the river felt like being the first person to explore a mysterious new universe. According to him, instruments had been left in the river in order to record its behavior, and researchers in the lab would explore what it is about the water that makes it special. The results of the team went much further than that. In fact, they had just set up their mooring a few days before the massive eruption of the Tongan volcano Hunga Tonga Hunga Hapai. As the tsunami moved through the cavity, the instruments used by the team picked up indications of a significant shift in the air pressure. Stevens was reminded by the effects of the eruption of just how interconnected everything on the planet is. Here we are in a forgotten corner of the world, witnessing in real time the influences of events that seem to be taking place on the other side of the world. It was really something to behold. There is another canyon that is equally as deep as the Grand Canyon. According to NASA, the massive hollow that is currently emerging on the western side of Antarctica is a force to be reckoned with. The cavity is approximately two-thirds the size of Manhattan and is almost 1,000 feet deep. It is situated near the base of the Thwaites Glacier, and if it maintains its current rate of expansion, then I'm sorry to say that we might be in some difficulty. The unsolved mysteries behind the Bloop. In 1997, an undersea enigma that came to be known as the Bloop took place. It was a sound that was so tremendously loud that it was recorded by many hydrophones that were located thousands of kilometers apart from one another. It was subsequently considered, read, still not confirmed, that the sound was caused by ice slamming into the seabed, despite the fact that many people initially thought the sound was caused by aquatic dinosaurs or undiscovered animals. A massive underground river has been uncovered. Using ice-penetrating radar that was placed on aircraft, researchers were able to locate a vast subsurface river that flows beneath four distinct ice sheets. In addition to being longer than the Tame River in England, this river empties into the Weddell Sea, the melting ice from an area that is larger than both France and Germany combined. It is possible that world sea levels may rise by 14.1 feet if the entire region were to melt as a result of climate change. this could have disastrous effects. Researchers are of the opinion that there is most likely an extensive network of underground rivers that spans the entire continent. The greatest iceberg waves goodbye. The Terra satellite operated by NASA took a picture of the world's largest iceberg, known as A76A, while it was beginning its journey out from Antarctica. The photo was taken as the iceberg was drifting in the opening of the Drake Passage, which is a stormy stretch of water in the Southern Ocean. The massive piece of ice, which measures approximately 84 miles in length and 16 miles in width, separated from the Ron ice shelf in 2021 for the first time. When icebergs enter the Drake Passage, they are normally quickly dragged eastward by strong ocean currents, and then they are whipped northward into warmer waters, where they quickly melt away completely. However, this year, icebergs have been lingering in the Drake Passage longer than usual. It is not known where A76A will wind up in the long run, or when it will fall into the water and meet its end. There are millions of fish nests here. The discovery of a treasure trove of 60 million ice fish nests dotting the floor of the Weddell Sea in Antarctica astounded the researchers who were working aboard an icebreaker ship at the time. The nests were found by accident through the use of a video feed from the ocean floor that was being monitored on board a research vessel that was primarily aiming to investigate whales. The distance between each nest was around 10 inches, and they were spread out over an area that was approximately 93 square miles. A guardian fish was stationed atop each nest, which had a total of approximately 1,700 eggs in each compartment. There were also many dead ice fish in the area, which is more evidence that the enormous ice fish colony is an essential component of the ecosystem in this region. These dead ice fish most likely serve as food for the local Weddell seal population. The new deepest point mapped. As a result of the creation of a new map of the Southern Ocean, scientists now have the most in-depth view to date of the seafloor that surrounds Antarctica, including its deepest point, which is known as the Factorian Deep. The Factorian Deep wasn't found until 2019, despite the fact that it lies approximately 7,437 meters below the surface of the ocean. This is equivalent to stacking 17 Empire State Buildings on top of each other. But up until this point, researchers had no idea how this feature related to the seafloor in the surrounding area. The new map, which encompasses more than 18.5 million square miles of the seafloor, was created with the help of more than 1,200 sets of sonar data that were acquired, for the most part by scientific vessels. The sea bottom chart is going to be used by the researchers in the hopes of locating underwater mountains, also known as seamounts, that could be important breeding grounds for marine species. The unearthing of 1-million-year-old DNA. When scientists were collecting routine samples of sediment from the seafloor in the Scotia Sea, they made an accidental discovery that led to the discovery of DNA from ancient microorganisms, some of which are approximately 1 million years old. The ancient genetic material was recovered at depths as much as 584 feet below the ocean. Its age ranges from approximately 1 million years ago to approximately 540,000 years ago. It is unknown to the scientific community which species the oldest DNA samples come from. However, the most recent samples almost certainly come from a kind of phytoplankton known as diatoms. The diatoms date back to an ancient age of global warming and may provide hints as to how the marine ecosystems of Antarctica will react to climate change induced by humans. There are more meteorites discovered here than in any other location on Earth. Since we are discussing meteorites right now, you should go to Antarctica in order to locate some. First of all, it's because the Antarctic has stayed largely unspoiled over all of this time, and we haven't yet dug them up to create a place for buildings. Secondly, the exceptionally dry temperature better maintains the granite compared to other environments, such as jungles. The bottom that defies logic and reason blossoms. Both of the Earth's polar regions have been found to harbor seemingly impossible phytoplankton blooms that are hiding deep beneath the surface of the ocean. These blooms have been discovered by separate teams of researchers. Prior to this discovery, scientists had the preconceived notion that there was insufficient light in the water that lay beneath the polar sea ice for phytoplankton to generate enough energy to thrive. However, the latest research has shown that the algae are able to flourish with as little as 1% of the light that is available at the surface. Researchers in Antarctica used deep diving floats to test the amount of chlorophyll A a pigment that is utilized by algae and other plants during the process of photosynthesis, in the water deep beneath the sea ice. They discovered that there was likely a significant concentration of phytoplankton in that area. The researchers have a hunch that the reduction in the amount of sea ice and its longevity that will occur as a result of climate change would assist these bottom blooms persist by allowing for an increase in the amount of light that they are exposed to. It previously existed as a rainforest. When one considers that in today's world, Antarctica is nothing more than a large expanse of ice that can cause frostbite and nothing but empty space, it may be challenging to come to grips with this reality. On the other hand, this region was once home to a verdant tropical rainforest before the onset of the Ice Age. This was a very long time ago. A huge lake was hidden beneath the ice. A lake the size of a metropolis was found buried deep below the East Antarctic ice sheet by a team of researchers. The hidden lake, which was given the name Lake Snow Eagle, covers an area of 143 square miles and is located in a canyon that is 1 mile deep. It is covered by ice that extends for 2 miles. After conducting rigorous aerial surveys across the ice sheet with radar and specialized sensors designed to monitor minute changes in the Earth's gravity for a period of 3 years, the crew finally discovered the lake. It is believed by experts that it may contain river sediments that are 34 million years old, making them older than the ice sheet itself. These sediments may provide insight into what Antarctica was like before it became covered in ice. Doomsday Glacier in danger. The Thwaites Glacier in Antarctica is known as the Doomsday Glacier, and it was observed by underwater robots that the glacier is only clinging to the bottom below by its fingernails at this point. After it separates, it will likely meet its end much sooner than anticipated due to the rapid movement it will undergo and the extreme spike in the amount of ice it will lose. A new map of the seafloor surrounding the icy giant reveals a sequence of parallel grooves that were left behind as the glacier scraped along the ocean bottom during previously unknown times of rapid retreat within the last several millennia. The grooves were discovered on the map as a result of the new map. Researchers are warning that another instance of this type of rapid melting could be brought on by unusually high temperatures brought on by climate change. There was a time when dinosaurs roamed around. Dinosaurs were, without a doubt, among the myriad types of wildlife that roamed the plains back when Antarctica was covered in verdant rainforests and served as their home. They roamed the expanses unhindered 100 million years ago, long before the asteroid that would bring about the extinction of our favorite extinct Jurassic monsters and set the Jurassic period to an end. That's all for the video today. We will be right back with more. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel.